Whoa!
Hey, you! Finally awake.
Welcome to the Backrooms, 600 million square miles of loneliness where you may not see other people for years. Just the stink of old moist carpet, the madness of mono yellow, and... wait, who are these guys? So initially, I was planning for my game to be single player only, but almost every single comment I've gotten on my videos has been asking me to add multiplayer. Even after I said I was gonna add multiplayer in my last video, every comment was still asking me to add it, so at this point, I really have no choice. So in single player games, you see everything through a first person camera, so you don't actually have a body, which would look kind of weird in multiplayer. So we're gonna have to set up character animations when you move around. Now, I'm not an animator by any stretch of the imagination, so we're gonna be using animations from a website called Mixamo. So I downloaded a few movement animations to set up an animation blueprint and use something called a blend space to get some smooth transitions between the animations. Then I realized that some of the animations didn't really fit the game.
Hey, I walk around like gang.
So after cleaning some of them up in Blender, they now work perfectly. So in single player, when you get killed by an entity, your camera just turns off. But in multiplayer, other people would just see your character disappear. So we're gonna have to figure out a way to spice up the way entities kill players in co-op mode. So it turns out there's actually a theory that says the entities in the backrooms are just really lonely and are really just trying to give you a big hug. Or not. Now a lot of people have been roasting my trailer and telling me to hire voice actors, and to that I say, who needs voice actors when you have proximity chat?
We've been trying to contact you regarding your car's extended warranty for quite some time now.
I also threw on this audio filter to voices so you sound like you're actually in the backrooms. This is my voice after one day in the backrooms.
This is my voice after 10,000 days in the backrooms. Send help, please.
I also made the entities hear your voice if you talk, so make sure to stay quiet if you're near them. Yo, do you see the exit anywhere? I think your mic is muted. Can you hear me?
Shut the fuck up!
So at this point, I took a break from working on multiplayer to add some suggestions for my Discord, which if you haven't joined yet, then you probably should. I'm adding suggestions from there pretty much every day, so if you want to play a part in this game, be sure to join with the link in the description. So the first thing everyone has been saying is that smilers aren't scary enough.
Why are you bullying me?
Now, some people said I should just make it a floating face, but I think that would make it even less scary. Now, the real issue is that in my last video, I made the mistake of showing the smiler outside of darkness. But in-game, it's always going to be in the dark, so all you'll see is its face. But to make it even scarier, I changed the face texture and made it bigger, so now it looks like a real threat. A lot of people have also been hating on level Run for Your Life for being too narrow, so I made it a tiny bit wider and turned it into a hospital hallway. I also added these props that get in your way while you're running, which you have to avoid. But make sure to go as fast as you can, or the giant horde of entities chasing you will catch up. So when I posted my first Backrooms video, everyone was telling me that the N was a trap level, and the real N was level 922-33720-36854-77-5807. So after spending all this time making that level, everyone is now saying that the actual final level is level 3999. So I'm kind of confused, so leave a comment down below which one is actually the last level. Now the most popular suggestion I've seen so far is to add guns. But I'm definitely not going to add them, because how are entities meant to be scary when you can just one-tap them as soon as you see them? So what I'm gonna do instead is add more levels. So the first one I'm gonna add is level 974, also known as level Mr. Kitty, which is this pink bedroom which looks like your sister's room. Or your room, I mean, no one's judging you here. So level 974 is a safe level with only one known entity that resides in it. The entity known as Kitty, who is a 3-meter tall humanoid entity with unnaturally long, lanky limbs, which seems to lack any semblance of facial features, and is only assumed by others to be able to see, hear, and... wait, why does this sound like a perfect description of me? The entity has not yet displayed any form of hostility, opting instead to creepily stalk wanderers as they explore and rest within level 974. So I got a model of this room from Pouchy Boy in my Discord and quickly added some props around and changed up textures to make it look like Kitty's room. Now everyone's been asking me how I model the entity, so here's a quick tutorial on making Mr. Kitty. So first we're gonna put a sphere here for his head, a cylinder here for his body, then two cylinders here for his arms, and two more here for his legs, and here it is, Mr. Kitty. Oh shit, Mr. Kitty. Hey, can I get some privacy here, or? So before I add more levels, be sure to hit the like button and subscribe, or you'll noclip into level 974. The next level I'm gonna add is level 94, which I teased in my last episode. Level 94 appears to be a large town with grass hills, but everything has a grainy effect, as if the place was crafted. The main town is safe with no entities during the day. So I used something called a height map to create these flowing hills, which is a texture with black and white, with black representing a height of 0 and white representing a height of 255, with the gray values being somewhere in the middle. So if I apply it to a landscape here, it gives us these perfect flowing hills. Then I modeled out a house in Blender and scattered them around. I also set up a day and night cycle, so if you aren't fast enough to escape during the day, you'll need to hide in the houses at night, and trust me, you don't want to go outside at night. And after adding some post-processing, we now have this, which looks a bit rough around the edges, so I'll definitely need to add some finishing touches to make it look more realistic before adding it to the game. I also decided to make some changes to the levels I already made, like completely redoing level 922-337-203685 to look more realistic, adding light rays to the pool rooms, and changing the wall texture in level 0. I also started working on level 5, which is a vintage 1930s hotel, level 6, which is this dark level where you have to listen to sounds to find the exit, and level 10, which is this giant field of wheat. But they're not gonna come until later updates. So when it comes to multiplayer, once you finish the game, it might get a bit boring until the next update comes out, so I'm gonna add multiple game modes. So the first game mode I'm gonna add is hide and seek, where one player is randomly chosen to be the entity, and the last person to survive wins, and it's every man for himself. So I added a mechanic where you can punch someone to stun them for a period of time, so be sure not to trust anyone who says they might be your friend.
Где я, блядь, здесь пахнет дерьмом?
Sure, let's hide over here.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine, when you're not really fine, but you just can't.
I feel kind of bad now. The next game mode I'm gonna add is survival, where you're randomly thrown into a level with up to a dozen people, which I might increase in an update depending on how it performs. And the people who survive move on to the next level, and the last person to survive wins. Just imagine a dozen people running away from the horde of entities and level run for your life just slapping each other. I also plan on adding game modes like infection in future updates, so be sure to subscribe so you don't miss my future videos where I make them. So before releasing the game on Steam, I had to do a lot of boring things like setting up all the menus, making the save system for levels, editing cutscenes, writing lore, and getting the sound effects made, which took up a lot of time. I also had to test multiplayer, which is kind of hard because I don't have any friends. So after testing the game out and fixing as many bugs as possible, it was finally ready for release. Well, not really. At this point, I've been working on this game for 4 months during every single minute that I'm not at school or work, so at this rate, it's gonna take me like 100 years to finally finish the game. So I decided to put the game into early access so those who want to play the game before it's fully done can do so, and that way I can take the time to set up an actual team to work on the game. Now some of the new maps and game modes aren't in the game yet since I want to make sure all the bugs are fixed before adding them, which are definitely expected, so don't flip out if you find any. And if you do noclip through the map, just remember that it's fully intentional and totally not a bug. Now I know a lot of people expected the game to be free since I had some confusing wording when I said wishlisting the game was free in an earlier video, which is totally my fault, but after going back and forth about it for a while now, I decided to make it paid since I plan on adding dedicated server support. That way it can handle hundreds of players in one game in a non-linear map layout, and dedicated servers are what most people would call really expensive. Oh, and if you haven't realized, it's out right now, and I'd highly recommend playing this game with a group of friends since it's definitely the most fun playing that way.
Run for your life, whoever blocked me, gotta run quicker, cause oh my god, y'all are taking so long!
And if you think the game is impossible, this guy right here beat the game with 4 people in nightmare mode, so congratulations to him, and also I'm very sorry for the pain and suffering you went through. But to everyone who has supported the game so far, thank you so much, since now I can take this project a lot more seriously, and in a few months, this game won't just be the best Backrooms game, but one of the best games on all of Steam. And with that being said, if you think the game is scary as it is now, then you're gonna shit your pants when I add VR support.